Praise the Lord and good morning from Pearl Haven Christian Center. My name is Pastor Patrick Angura, here to bring you the third nugget for this week on our topic of being thankful. Today we look at the second reason to be thankful to God is for our salvation. The fact that we are born again, our salvation has been given to us. God has given us the book of my famous portion of scripture. One of my best scriptures in the Bible is 1 John chapter 5 verse 11 to 13, which says, and this is the testimony, God has given us eternal life. This life is in the Son. Whoever has the Son has life. Whoever doesn't have the Son does not have life. God has already given us eternal life. So we need to be thankful to God as Christians for our salvation. And our salvation means a lot. And God has provided every resource to make sure that we make it to our destiny in heaven with Him. And so that's amazing. That is a very powerful reason, a very good reason to be thankful to God. Because our salvation means that we have a very excellent destiny for our souls in eternity with God Himself. And you see, to ensure that happens, the Bible says He's given us His Holy Spirit as a guarantee of this promise of our salvation or the salvation of our souls. So to make sure this happens, He supplied grace, and His grace has been supplied or given to us so that every gap that we have gets filled. So His grace covers gaps that probably would show, the cracks that would show in our walk with Him. He supplied us grace to fill all these inadequacies in our lives. Also, we can count on His faithfulness, because He's a faithful God, to ensure that we make it to heaven. Scripture is so clear, it's so assuring that we are ending up with God in our eternity. He has also provided power, and His power that He has provided to us is to make sure that this happens. So it's not by our might, not by our strength, not by our plans, but by the power of God to make sure that that which He has promised us comes to pass. We reach that destination that He has already predestined for us. He's also given us mercy. And the Bible says it endures forever. Psalms 136 verse 1, verse 2, verse 3, and verse 26 all say the same thing, that His mercy endures forever. You would wonder why somebody repeats one thing like that. It says His mercy endures forever. And the fact that His mercy endures means that we actually try the mercy of God through the way that we behave, through our gaps in life. We try the mercies of God. But the Bible says the mercies endure. Just like if you saw a rock near water, maybe in the on the lakeside or riverside, when wind is flowing, it has tried it for years. Water is slapping the rock, gushing towards the rock, but the rock has been there. It has endured. And that's what's happening with us. The mercy of God. We try it in many ways. We really shake it, but God has been faithful to make sure that we remain on course. And so then He has provided His Holy Spirit to make sure He helps us. He's our helper. And then His love is there to ensure we make it to the promised land. Thank you. Let's be thankful. God bless you.